السلام علیکم پبلک، تو کیا حال چال ہیں آپ کے؟ امید کرتا ہوں کہ یار آپ لوگ ٹھیک ٹھاک ہوں گے۔ تو یار سب سے پہلے ویلکم ٹو مائی گیمنگ چینل جس کا نام ہے مارخور گیمنگ۔ اگر آپ نے چینل کو سبسکرائب نہیں کیا تو یار چینل کو جلدی جلدی سبسکرائب کر دیں اور ساتھ میں بیل آئیکن کو دبا دیں۔
Wasting any time, are you?
Your little rampage is going to attract attention. Attention from people I don't care to associate with.
Yeah, imagine not.
Thankfully, closing off your loose ends is as simple as tossing around some super grade. With any luck, this will keep them off my ass. For a little while, anyway. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. There's still the matter of killing Georgie and Sal. You should get a kick out of hearing this.
Goddamn motherfucking piece of shit!
Lou's dead. They found him tied to that statue of Eddie Jackson over in the French ward.
He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
Jesus fucking Christ.
This was that goddamn nigga licking Clay. We would not be in this fucking mess if you'd done what you were supposed to do.
You in here? I shot him right in the fucking head.
Once! You shot him once! I am leveraged out the ass! Called in every favor, and none of it made a goddamn difference. We're fucked. I am fucked.
Oh, now that's bullshit. We still got some men. I say we hit the streets and we find that cocksucker.
Every low-life ball of piss in this city smells blood in the water. My blood. Do you understand? And they'd step over their own mother if it meant being the one that clipped me. I wouldn't last 10 fucking minutes out there.
That's a crock of shit. You forget? You are Sal Marcano. Well, there's got to be something we can do.
Call whatever men we still have left. Tell them meet us up there at the casino. When Lincoln Clay shows up, we're gonna do everything we can to plant that goddamn nigga in the ground. Right next to us. That's what we can do. Go on, get the fuck out of here. Go!
Should have known that Marcano would go to ground at the casino.
You can take the bridge up there so it's a straight shot.
You know, none of this would have happened without you.
bumper for this asshole. Gonna feed you to my fucking hogs.
I'm ducking down.
Get that stupid son of a bitch. To run now, boy! Hit him from the other side!
Bullseye, motherfucker!
Supplies! Run him, go! Got this!
Fuck! Reloaded!
Here comes a war...
Come, cousin, motherfucker!
Shit! Fucking stuck!
Slip behind him!
Here we go!
That shit's all.
Going out like that.
The fuck? Get him!
You let the boys downstairs handle
yes!
it.
Yes!
It's what they get paid for.
Finally, we're alone!
I ain't come here to watch someone else do all the work. I came here to bury that cocksucker. Just like we said. Be careful, yeah? I ain't the one you need to be worried about.
Spider one, boys!
Fucking dropping us!
Thinking you stupid fuck, you should not have come here!
Come get me, boy!
You cocksucker, you brought all this on yourself! I just told me to stop by, I'd have had the kids whip something up!
These motherfuckers can't protect you, Georgie, it's over!
Go, motherfuckers, die first!
gonna break him in half.
Kill one of our boys.
He's empty. Get him.
Hold him.
He's fucking up for those.
Get your ass around him.
You stupid motherfucker.
I always thought you were my friend. That you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me. Owned all of us.
It was never about us. About my old man, my father. I did anything for him. Same as you and Sammy.
And you understand why I have to do this.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. You want a drink?
All right.
Had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Now, usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Doesn't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. Giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. Was another one where cottonmouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was Georgie's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. And all of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
Imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And then this. This was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people. More than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, sir. Here we are. My son is dead. And I'm having a drink with his killer. I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. There's only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it.
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally, a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here. Right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Wanna sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So, what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just 'cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's going to shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't going to be me, it's going to be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hey. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. Oh. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear?
about?
A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
After Lincoln Clay vanished, Thomas Burke assumed control of the city. According to his daughter, Burke's liver was riddled with cancer. He should have lived maybe, another 6 months. But that selfish bastard used the money Lincoln left him to go to Mexico and get a black market transplant. And then he hung around for another 16 years. Now, he flooded the city with booze, then expanded into drugs, first heroin, then cocaine. He used the same infrastructure he'd set up for moonshining, and within a year or so, most of the cocaine entering the country came through here. Anyway, Burke was one of the wealthiest men in the southern United States. Hell, he bought himself a seat on the city council and got the township's name legally changed to Bourbon City. But all that cocaine attracted other criminals, and Burke went to war with the Cuban gang. Shootouts in the streets, car bombs, a brothel burned to the ground. When the Cubans called him out, Burke came, armed with an M60 and grenades. He killed 8 men before they put him down, and that was 1984. And since then, no one has sat on the throne for more than a few months. The city is still a lawless fool's paradise. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. Trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.